Hello friends, hope you have studied our last lecture. Okay, in last lecture we have already started to learn about the homo alkane, haloalkane and haloarenes. Okay, in that we have started the preparation methods. Okay, I will revise shortly and then I will start the new preparation methods. Hope you have seen that videos. Okay, I have tried to catch that video using the whiteboard and chalk and board method. Okay, hope it is impressive than this. Okay, otherwise you have to tell me which method is better for the understanding. Okay, so I will share the screen. In that we'll take the book. Okay, hope you can see the book. See, the method of preparation, the first method which we have already learned from the alcohol. Okay, see the first method here, the alcohol which is ROH, general alcohol. General means this is alkyl alcohol. Okay, here this R is methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl, like that. Here we have taken HX. HX means again X is belongs to halogen family. Okay, X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, anyone. Okay, this alcohol when react with this alkyl or hydrogen halide, yesterday we have taken example of HCl. Okay, hydrochloric acid, that I have. And then here is the catalyst. Okay, and using this catalyst, zinc chloride, you can easily prepare this alkyl halide. Okay, our targeted molecule and the side product is water. Okay, the second method which we have learned is alcohol in presence of sodium bromide and with the help of sulfuric acid. Okay, and sulfuric acid again as a catalyst, and you will get alkyl bromide and the side product. Then third method, it was for alcohol in presence of phosphorus trichloride. In that phosphorus trichloride, you will get the three molecule of alkyl halide, and here is the phosphoric acid. The name of this compound is H3PO3. Yesterday we have not written this one. Okay, so better you can correct it in your notebook and check what we have written here. Okay, so this is H3PO3, means phosphoric acid. Okay, then the fourth method is alcohol using the phosphorus pentachloride, and you will get the alkyl chloride. Okay, when we will use the specific halogen here instead of X5O, then if we have taken here chlorine, we have to prepare here chlorine. Okay, and then side product is POCl3, which is HCl. Okay, and then alcohol in presence of red phosphorus or any dihalide, specifically dibromide or diiodine, you will get the alkyl halide. And the sixth method, this is thionyl chloride, alcohol in presence of thionyl chloride, and you will get alkyl chloride, and the side product is sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid. Here we have written that both sulfuric acid and hydrochloric acid are in gaseous state. So there is a possibility of both of them will be evaporated, and easily you will get the RCl, means alkyl halide. So this method is very robust method or very good method to prepare the alkyl halide. Okay, then the next method which we have learned is from hydrocarbons. Okay, and the hydrocarbons, we have learned the first method, which is free radical halogenation, which is in presence of UV light, that we have written here, ultraviolet light. Okay, we have taken the example of N-butane. This is N-butane, 4-carbon hydrocarbon, name is N-butane, and in presence of chlorine and ultraviolet light, you will get two type of products. Maybe this is 1-chlorobutane or 2-chlorobutane. Okay. So this is from the hydrocarbon we have prepared the alkyl halide or chloroalkane. Okay, then the next method yesterday which we have not seen, this method is electrophilic substitution method. Okay, to preparation of haloarene using electrophilic substitution. So what is electrophile? What is electrophile? Electrophile is having which charge, positive or negative? Positive charge. Suppose we have this dihalogen. Suppose for example we have taken this dibromo. Okay, dibromo or bromine molecule, means 2 Br are there. In that bromine, 1 Br will be positive, another Br will be negative. So that positive bromine will attack on here, okay, on benzene ring, and there will be attachment on these two types. Okay, and the catalyst is in presence of iron chloride or iron. See, like iron or iron chloride, Fe or FeCl3. Okay. And in presence of iron chloride, there will be a formation of CR. What there will be formation? This is means orthohalogen or parahalogen. What is ortho and para? The benzene ring when is substituted. Here is the methyl group, the called is toluene. Toluene is the name of this starting material. Okay, so in that toluene, if their adjacent positions are called as ortho, then number two positions are called as the meta, and the last position, which is fourth position from here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So fourth position from this side, or 1, 2, 3, 4 from this side, you will get the para type of product. Means there are three positions, mainly ortho, meta and para. Out of these, due to electrophilic substitution, you will get two type of products. One is ortho products, another is the para products. Okay. The ortho and para isomers can be easily separated due to large difference in melting point and so on. Okay. So fluorine compound will not be prepared, because fluorine is, or fluorine type of compounds are highly reactive. Okay. Then next method which we have already seen is Sandmeer reaction. I have not intentionally given you the name of that reaction, which is Sandmeer, but which is very famous reaction. And the starting material of this reaction is aniline. Okay, yesterday we have already seen this aniline. Okay, the benzene ring having amine group. Okay, primary amine or NH2 group. And in that, we have to add the NaNO2. NaNO2 is sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite. Write down the good spelling. Okay. And then in NaNO2 plus any hydrochloric acid or hydrobromic acid, and you will get the diazonium salt. So I have written here the benzene diazonium halide. Okay. And when you will use benzene diazonium halide in presence of copper chloride or Cu2X2, means general term is there again. Okay, so either Cl or either bromine. Okay, then you will get aryl halide, and nitrogen molecule will be evolved on that range. Understand? So this name of reaction is Sandmeyer reaction. Okay, so specifically, or this is very important reaction in the point of examination. Okay, the next method to prepare, and yes, and here even we have yesterday given that using this diazonium salt we can add directly potassium iodide. Okay, if we have to prepare the iodobenzene, then we have to add Ki. There what we have added, here we have added this one, okay, copper halide. Instead of copper halide, you can add directly potassium iodide, and you will get the iodobenzene. Okay, and this iodobenzene means haloarene is there. Okay, the another method to prepare the alkyl halide, which is from alkenes. What is alkene? Alkene means hydrocarbon having double bond. Okay, is called as the alkene. So first example we can take is, which is ethene molecule. Which is this molecule? Ethene or ethylene molecule. Okay, and if we have added in this ethylene molecule this hydrochloric acid, hydrobromic acid, like that. Okay, HX molecule. Then there will be addition of HX molecule on this double bond. Means one hydrogen atom will attach first carbon, and remaining halogen atom will attach on remaining carbon. Okay, so this type of addition will be there. All carbon is satisfied with four valency, and you will get the molecule which is what we can say is haloalkane. Okay, haloalkane. Suppose there is another rule in propene. Okay, see here, the molecule is propene, CH3CHCH2. Okay, if CH3CHCH2 is there, and if we have added this HI, what will happen? Hydrogen will attach here, and the iodine will attach here. Okay, these two adjacent carbons. There is another possibility, because this CH and CH2 are not similar. Hey, remember, see here carefully. In these three carbons, all three carbons are not equivalent. Okay, this is CH3, this is CH, and this is CH2. So there is a possibility when this HI will add in it, sometimes hydrogen will attach here or hydrogen will attach here, and vice versa. Means iodine will attach here or iodine will attach here. So which probability is more? So see here, when iodine is attached, or any halogen will attach on this last carbon, okay, means having no substitution, so that type of carbon, primary carbon, that compound is minor. And when this iodine is added in middle carbon, okay, so that type of possibility to prepare the carbon is prepare this compound, halogen compound, is major. Okay, so this you will get in major amount. Okay, so this is actually the one rule is there, and the name of that rule is Mark-Onikoff's rule. Hope you remember from chapter 11, okay, unit 13 in 11th standard. Okay, there we have already learned the Mark-Onikoff rule. Okay, so Mark-Onikoff says that when the negative atom is attached to the more substituted carbon, which is predominantly available, means majorly it will form. Okay. Then another method, addition of halogen on alkene instead of HI. See, instead of HI or instead of HCl, instead of HBr, here we can add directly X2, okay, Cl2, Br2, like that. What will happen here? When you will add Cl2 or Br2, then there is a possibility of these two halogen will attach in both two carbon atoms. Okay, so in both two carbon atoms means there is a formation of vicinal dibromide. Write down the term here, the vicinal dibromide. Initially we have learned the term, the geminal dibromide and vicinal dibromide. When the two halogen atoms is attached on the same carbon, means geminal dihalide, and the two halogen atoms when attached to the adjacent carbon atom is called as vicinal dibromide. Okay, so there is a possibility to prepare the vicinal dibromide. Okay, you have to solve these examples also, even though they have already solved it here. Okay, see here, this is double bond compound and HBr addition. Okay, what will happen here? Yes, when you will add it here, then where hydrogen will go and where bromine will go. So here you have to use the Markovnikov's rule. The same thing with here. We have butene molecule and HCl, then using Markovnikov's rule. Here they have intentionally given here peroxide. Peroxide means we have to use anti-Markovnikov's rule. So whatever you are thinking to get it, you have to write down the opposite type of product. Means the bromine, instead of middle carbon or secondary carbon, we have to attach it on primary carbon because of peroxide. Okay, so here you have to write answer of anti-Markovnikov's rule. Okay, we will move further. Now the reaction of halogen exchange. Okay, reaction of halogen exchange. What it means? When now we have prepared the alkyl halide. Now we have to prepare something from alkyl halide. Okay, so reaction of alkyl halide. So there is a halogen exchange reactions. So starting material is also halogen, and the product is also halogen. But important is, the starting halogen is, see here, we have written the example is chlorine or bromine. Then there will be possibility to change when you react with this. Suppose this is RCl and then any AI, iodine is there. And there will be exchange of Ri and NX. Okay, NX may be Cl or bromine. So this type of reaction, this halogen exchange type of reaction is called as Finkelstein reaction. Write down there. Again, very important reaction, which is Finkelstein reaction. Finkelstein. Okay? Means halogen exchange reaction. Okay. There is another reaction. When sodium chloride and NaBr, thus formed, is precipitated in triacetone, it facilitates the forward reaction according to Lee-Chatler principle. Okay, म्हणजे H का reaction होत नाही NaCl आणि NaBr. The synthesis of alkyl chloride is best accomplished by heating an alkyl chloride bromide in the presence of a metallic chloride such as silver chloride, mercury chloride, cobalt chloride, or antimony chloride. The reaction term as Schwartz reaction. ज्यात काय इथं Schwartz reaction आहे. Okay. आणि यामध्ये फ्लोराइड बनवायचे आहेत पण ज्या ज्या हॅलोजनचा आपण कधीच उल्लेख केलेला नव्हता. ओके, वी हॅव नेहर नेवर थिंक अबाउट द फ्लोरो कंटेनिंग ऑफ अल्केन इन बिफोर रिएक्शन. ओके, बट वी कॅन प्रिपेअर सच काइंड ऑफ फ्लोरो कंपाउंड यूजिंग दिस सिल्वर फ्लोराइड और दिस फोर टाइप ऑफ डिफरंट कंपाउंड आर देअर. बेस्ड ऑन दॅट वी कॅन प्रिपेअर इट. सी हियर द एज अ एक्झाम्पल द मिथिल ब्रोमाइड इज देअर. मिथिल ब्रोमाइड विन रिएक्ट विथ सिल्वर फ्लोराइड देन देर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ हॅलोजन ग्रुप अँड यू विल गेट द मिथिल फ्लोराइड अँड सिल्वर ब्रोमाइड. ओके, सो सच काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज स्वार्ट्झ रिएक्शन. मी असं लक्षात ठेवलं होतं क्लोरिन स्वार्ट्झ रिएक्शन. ओके, लक्षात ठेवा जे क्लोरिन स्वार्ट्झ रिएक्शन म्हणलं म्हणजे लगेच क्लिक होतो तुम्हाला की क्लोरिन तयार करण्याची रिएक्शन. ओके, सो क्लोरिन स्वार्ट्झ रिएक्शन असं यू कॅन टेल. आणि इथं फिंकलस्टेन रिएक्शन विच इज हॅलोजन एक्सचेंज रिएक्शन इज नॉट ओनली फॉर आयोडीन ऑर ऑल्सो यू कॅन राईट डाऊन देअर आयोडीन फिंकलस्टेन रिएक्शन. ओके, अँड फ्लोरिन स्वार्ट्झ रिएक्शन. So you can easily recognize it. Okay, again these examples you have to solve it. If there is a problem we will discuss on it. Okay, then what about the physical properties? Okay, when alkyl halides are colorless, alkyl halides are colorless when pure. However, bromides and iodides develop color when exposed to light. Many volatile halogen compounds have sweet smell. Halogen compounds smell can sweet. Okay, what about melting and boiling points? Okay, we'll check here. The methyl chloride, methyl bromide, all are gases same stage. Then ethyl also gases. Iodides, let's see. Okay. Are some chlorofluoromethanes are gases at room temperature? Higher members are liquids or solids? As we have already learned, molecules of organic halogen compounds are generally polar due to greater polarity as well as high molecular mass as compared to the parent hydrocarbon. The intermolecular forces of attraction are stronger in the halogen derivatives. That is why the boiling points of chloride, bromide and iodides are considerably higher than those of the hydrocarbons of comparable molecular mass. The attractions get stronger as the molecule get bigger in size and have more electrons. The pattern of variation of boiling points of different halides are depicted for the same alkyl group. The boiling point of alkyl halides decrease in the order. Boiling points, if iodo alkane is there, which is more than the chloroalkane. This is because with the increase in size and mass of halogen atom, the magnitude of van der Waals forces also increase. The boiling point of isomeric haloalkanes, see here for the comparison. So this is bromobutane or n-bromobutane having boiling point higher than this 2-bromobutane, then higher than this tertiary butyl bromide. Okay, so if these branches are there, because of branches the boiling point will decrease. Okay, here 75, here 46 is there. Boiling points of isomeric dihalobenzenes are very nearly the same. However, the para isomers are high melting as compared to their ortho and meta isomers. Okay, see here comparison. This is ortho, this is meta, and this is para. So boiling point, yes, is almost the same. no need to think. But here, yes, ortho and meta, this is para. Para melting point is too high. Okay, so bromo iodo density chart is also there. You can read, this is theoretical, so no need to think on that too much. Theoretical and solubility is also there. The haloalkanes are only very slightly soluble in water. Okay, so better today's lecture you have to remember the thing is the preparation methods of haloalkanes or haloarenes. First method which we have prepared from the alcohols, then from the hydrocarbons, then from the alkenes, then we have learned the Sandmeyer reaction, then halogen exchange reaction. Then in that halogen exchange there are two reactions, that fluorine Schwartz reaction as well as the iodine Finkelstein reaction. Okay, so you have to keep in mind that reaction rather than this physical part. Okay, and tomorrow the next lecture we will start with reaction of haloalkanes. Okay, please revise it, try to solve these all questions which they have given in the book, and try to solve it. Write down or please note some notes on your notebook and try to send the screenshot of that. Okay, thank you very much.